people who are not wedded to a political party. And in those, independents are overwhelmingly siding with the belief that the Biden administration is not addressing crime at all. And take what Jen Psaki said there, is what even...
Pete Hegseth is co-host of Fox and Friends Weekend. Pete, glad to have you in focus today. Let's just start with who took the survey, disapprove of the president's handling of gun violence. 64% disapprove of how he's handling crime overall. Pete Hegseth is co-host of Fox and Friends Weekend. Pete, glad to have you in focus today. Let's just start with that. Get your reaction to those numbers, those statistics about where the president is on violence and crime.
Well, those numbers don't lie. People see what's happening in their own communities, in our major cities, and they make decisions for themselves, not based on the spin from the White House. If you look at those numbers a little deeper, look at the numbers with independents, people who are not wedded to a political party. And in those, independents are overwhelmingly siding with the belief that the Biden administration is not addressing crime at all. And take what Jen Psaki said there, is what even is soft on crime policies? They can't own up to it because the summation of their policies are to be soft on crime, whether it's criminals or illegals, because they know what soft on crime policies, because they've been critical of tough on crime policies of Republicans and others who crack down on crime too hard. Well, if you want to be for another approach, what do you want to call it? And you know what average people, like 69% of Americans, call it? Soft on crime. When you're not deporting people who are criminals, when you're facilitating transportation across the country, when you're letting people go repeat violent offenders, when bail is effectively ignored, when prosecutions are not happening of major crimes, when theft doesn't matter, when assaulting a police officer is just a petty misdemeanor and people are released. That is the very definition of soft on crime. And it is Democrat-run cities, counties, and states where this is prevalent. And as a result, we're seeing cops being shot at in broad daylight, not in just dangerous neighborhoods, but in prominent neighborhoods. And that might be the moment when someone like Jen Psaki wakes up. There was a little bit of that moment in Los Angeles. Remember that when Beverly Hills and Hollywood and these other places were seeing some violent crime, the politicians finally said, whoa, not in my backyard. Maybe it's coming somewhere else, but it's obvious that soft on crime policies are leading to this.
Look, there'll be a couple of times when we can measure their response, right? The next time Jen Psaki or someone with the White House is asked about it, maybe try a new idea for once. I mean, they're going to laugh. They're going to panic. Strategy's never on the list. I mean, when you ask about these things, you get a giggle from Jen Psaki. You get panic yesterday as the president sat with the National Governors Association, opened the room up for questions, and then they went, oh my gosh, get the media out of here. We didn't, you know, they didn't know he was going to do that. It was supposed to be just for the governors. But you don't see strategy. It's amazing. Let's get to this, because you mentioned our loss with officers right now.